What if I told you that the most athletic basketball player who played for the Chicago Bulls wasn't Michael Jordan? Sacrilegious as it may sound, it's probably true. At his best, Derrick Rose was the most explosive guard to play the game of basketball. Here's the story of the youngest MVP in league history, how injuries derailed his career, and how utterly amazing he was in his prime. Getting drafted. Rose grew up in the poorest part of Chicago, and it was a classic American basketball story that features a single mother, poverty, and drug dealers on every corner. But Derrick was determined to succeed and escape from the projects. He was highly recruited coming out of high school, and he ultimately accepted the scholarship at the University of Memphis, where he played under Coach Calipari. Rose led the Memphis Tigers to a 38-2 overall record and a trip to the NCAA Finals. But the Kansas Jayhawks got the best of them in the overtime of the championship game. Rose then declared for the NBA draft, where his home team, the Chicago Bulls, had only a 1.7% chance to win the 2008 draft lottery. And as if fate wanted it to happen, that the local kid ended up playing for the team he supported his whole life, the Bulls indeed won the lottery and selected the 6'3" Derrick Rose with their first overall pick. A quick rise to superstardom. It didn't take Rose long to get acclimated to the NBA. Athletically, he was instantly in the upper echelon of NBA players, and there was almost nobody that could match Rose's lightning-quick first step or stay up with him once he got airborne. He defied the laws of physics with his speed, and his dunks looked like he had an invisible trampoline beneath the hoop, and he was the only one jumping off it every single time. Like a miniature LeBron, Rose was absolutely unstoppable in the open court. As he galloped down the floor, he was in complete control of his body and in complete control of the ball, ready to either run around you or jump over you. With the averages of 17-6-4, D. Rose dominantly won Rookie of the Year award and led the Bulls to the playoffs. In his playoff debut against the defending champion Boston Celtics, Rose recorded 36 points, tying the NBA record for most points in a playoff debut by a rookie. Even though the Bulls lost the series in 7 games, it was clear that they had a superstar in the making. Most valuable player. In his sophomore season, Rose improved on his terrific rookie campaign and became the first Chicago Bull since Michael Jordan to be named an All-Star. The Bulls reached the playoffs again, but they would once more lose in the first round, despite Rose averaging 27 points and 7 assists against LeBron and the Cavs. Derrick Rose was a quiet, introverted guy, and he didn't talk too much, but it was clear as day that every loss hurts him deeply and that he is dying to bring a championship back to Chicago. So the next season, he came back with a vengeance. In the best shape of his life, D. Rose was an unsolvable mystery for the defenders around the league. All Rose needed was just a little crack in the defense and a little bit of open space, and he was gone. He would turn on the Jets and explode to the rim in a fraction of a second, leaving the defenders stuck in the mud. Led by Rose's 25 points, 4 rebounds, and almost 8 assists on average, the Bulls had the best record in the regular season. At just 22 years of age, Rose was named the NBA MVP, becoming the youngest player ever to win the award. However, LeBron was once again too strong, and he and the Heat defeated the Bulls in the Eastern Conference Finals in 5 games. 2012, the best and worst year of his career. Even though he was injured for a big chunk of the 2012 season and his numbers dropped off a little bit, Derrick Rose was playing the best basketball of his life. He started the year with a game winner against the Lakers, and throughout the season, he seemed more poised, more mature, and even more deadly. The Bulls finished with the best record in the league again, and it seemed like they finally had the talent and depth to go all the way. They opened the playoffs against the 8-seed Philadelphia 76ers and had the game in control, leading by 12 with a minute remaining. Rose should have been substituted and icing his knees by then, but the stubborn coach Thibodeau liked to keep his starters on the floor until the final whistle. So, with a minute left in the game, Rose made a move to the basket with a quick change of direction, a move that he successfully made thousands of times, but not on that damned April 13th. Rose fell to the ground and stayed there, grabbing his knee and screaming in pain. His ACL was gone, which is the worst injury for an athletic point guard. Derrick Rose, as we knew him then, ceased to exist. Recovery, injury, repeat. In recent NBA history, there hasn't been a player with worse injury luck than Derrick Rose. After he tore his ACL in the 2012 playoffs, he missed the entire 2013 campaign, only to get injured again 10 games into the 2014 regular season. This time, it was the other knee that gave out, and he missed the rest of that season as well. Once he returned, he was no longer the same. The name in his ID still said Derrick Rose. That man no longer existed. Not like that, not like we were used to. That Derrick Rose that could jump out of the gym and fly through the air, He died on April 13th in Chicago in the playoff game against the 76ers. He was replaced by a much less athletic version of his former self. Rose was still speedy and shifty, but the lift was gone. There were no more crazy acrobatics around the hoop, no more coast-to-coast dunks. His wings were clipped and he was no longer Air Rose. We who loved him, and there were a lot of us, did not stop hoping that he would return to his old form. We nurtured that hope for 3 years, and the great Derrick Rose games still happened occasionally, like the game winner against the Cavs in the playoffs, but those occasions were sparse, unfortunately. Rose became a former star who lost his abilities abruptly and never adapted to a new situation. During his later seasons with the Bulls and the 1 year he spent with the Knicks, he was a volume scorer who played inefficient basketball. Despite solid averages of 18 points and almost 5 assists per game during that span, it was clear that we have seen the best of Derrick Rose already, and that it happened before 2012, or at least so we thought, pondering retirement and the 50-point game. 3 knee surgeries, wrists, hip, back, fingers, groin, elbow, and even a bone in his face that obstructed his vision. Those were all the things Derrick broke, bruised, pulled, or had surgery on. His medical carton looked like a human anatomy exam, and after a while, it started affecting his psyche. You can repair an ACL, but a sane psyche is much harder to regain once there's a crack in it. And there was definitely a crack, because Rose was fed up. He was tired of constant injuries and rehabilitations, and during his time with the Cavs in 2018, he seriously considered retirement, even though he was only 28 years old at the time. His numbers plummeted, he barely played, and nobody wanted to have anything to do with him. And then, like many times before in his life, Derrick Rose rose from the ground, dusted himself off, and started playing the most efficient basketball of his career. Playing for the Timberwolves in the 2019 season, Rose was finally healthy and he had a clear idea who he was as a player. He was no longer trying to be the high flyer of the past, but he crafted his game around speedy cuts to the basket, floaters, and a newly found jump shot. Rose averaged 18 points and 4 assists for the season, and the absolute highlight was his 50-point game against the Utah Jazz on Halloween of 2018. The 50 points he scored were his career high, and Rose also made a game-winning block in overtime, after which he bursted into tears, emotional that he had such a game after all the injuries. But as great of a game that was, we will not remember Derrick Rose for it and for what he is doing now as a member of the Knicks. No. We will remember him for the dunk he had on Goran Dragic, which has to be in the top 10 dunks ever in my opinion. We will remember him for crazy acrobatic layups where he made it look like he was walking through the air. We will remember brutal dunks, a player nobody could outrun in transition, and clutch shots he wasn't afraid to take. Legacy. Despite not being the best player in the league in any of the years he played, there was no player in the entire league who would make jaws drop to the floor more often than Derrick Rose. D. Rose took our breath away every time he stepped on the court, and we all asked ourselves the same question: how was this kind of speed and athleticism humanly possible? If he and the Bulls had remained healthy, he probably would have won a title or two. But that's somehow less important in the Derrick Rose story. What's important is the perseverance and will to come back after multiple serious injuries, and all the flashy dunks that preceded them. To sum it up, and with no offense to Russell Westbrook, Derrick Rose was the most athletic point guard in NBA history, and that Derrick Rose will live in my memory forever.